Hello everyone! Today I'll tell you about the first of the metals mastered by a man, copper. In the periodic table of chemical elements, copper is in the 11th group, the so-called trio of the precious metal, copper, silver and gold. According to the archaeological data, humanity started creating the first copper products in 6th or 7th millennium BC, that is around 9000 years ago. Due to its low activity, copper was the first metal acquired by a human in its purest form. The process of obtaining copper is very simple. It starts with a malachite ore, or also known as a basic copper carbonate. Then it's mixed with charcoal, and after that is ignited. The result is carbon monoxide gas, which recovers copper from malachite to a metallic state. The resulting copper can be melted and then processed to then create something out of it. The Latin name for copper, cuprum, comes from the island of Cyprus, where there were rich deposits of malachite ore. Copper is sometimes found in the form of nuggets, covered with patina, which is the basic copper carbonate. To demonstrate the chemical properties of copper, let's take the same basic carbonate or malachite ore, but a more pure version than the one you can find in nature. When ammonia is being mixed with the basic copper carbonate, it forms a soluble ammonia complex of copper. This reaction can be used to clean copper products from patina. However, instead of ammonia, the smell of which will make you want to run away as fast as you can. You could use a less smelly substance, Trilon B, as it's also a good complexing agent. Metallic copper is a very stable and low activity metal. That is why the spires of all churches were covered with copper sheaths, as it protects the roof for many years. Metallic copper is not soluble in dilute sulfuric and hydrochloric acids, as it's located after hydrogen in the reactivity series of metals. However, copper reacts quite actively with the concentrated nitric acid, forming nitrogen dioxide, a brown gas with an unpleasant odor, and copper nitrate. If we look at the copper compounds, the most common copper salt in everyday life is of course copper sulfate. It's used for disinfection of plants from insects and also in analytical chemistry. If you add sodium hydroxide to copper sulfate, the copper hydroxide precipitate will fall out, which can be used to determine the presence of sugar in fruits. Let's add some grade apple into the glass of copper hydroxide and then heat the mixture. Over time, the glucose contained within apple juice recovers copper from a bivalent state to univalent, and after a while the solution becomes orange. In the cup, an oxide of copper 1 was formed from the copper hydroxide. That is a qualitative reaction that shows the presence of glucose in the apple. The oxide of monovalent copper dissolves in ammonia solution, forming monovalent copper ammonium complex. Compounds of the monovalent copper are colorless, but with the oxidation of this solution with hydrogen peroxide, the solution turns blue due to the oxidation of copper to the divalent state. Also, if you mix blue copper hydroxide and glycerol, the solution will turn bright blue due to the formation of copper glycerate, which is also a qualitative reaction for checking polyhedric alcohols. In general, copper compounds are used in many analytical reactions, which can determine even the alcohol concentration in a solution. There is also another interesting reaction, which can be used to obtain a copper mirror. In the cup with the solution of copper sulfate, a powerful reducing agent is poured, the solution of hydrazine. The nitrogen atoms in hydrazine are being oxidized and the copper is recovered from the solution to a metallic state, coating the walls of the glass with a sparkly, beautiful copper layer. However, the properties of copper sulfate do not end there. If you heat the well-known blue copper sulfate, it will turn white, because when heated, the crystals of copper sulfate lose water, leaving a white and hydrous copper sulfate. If you add water to this copper sulfate, the blue color will return, and the water rejoins the molecule of copper sulfate, forming crystalline. If you put copper sulfate into a flame, it will turn green because of the copper ions. By itself, the metal copper is one of the best conductors of heat and electricity. Because of this property, wires for many devices are now made of copper, and also the heat sinks in computers. This property of copper to conduct electricity well, I'll demonstrate with my next experiment. Let's observe how a powerful neodymium magnet will drop onto the surface of the table. And now, let's compare with the fall of the magnet onto a copper plate. You can see that the magnet fell slower onto the copper plate. This effect occurs because the currents generated within the copper plate caused by the movement of the magnet. The so-called induction effect can be stretched if we cool down the copper plate with liquid nitrogen. The magnet hangs over the plate much longer now, as by cooling, the internal resistance of copper has dropped, and the resulting current can exist longer. If you make a special ceramic, which in addition to copper also includes yttrium, barium and oxygen, we can get a superconductor, the current in which is infinite, and the magnet above it can levitate indefinitely, while the ceramic is being cooled with liquid nitrogen. Today copper is used for making the copper pipes. It is also included into the composition for many alloys, such as bronze alloys, cupronickel and others. Many people know the expression blue blood. In fact, there are creatures on Earth whose blood is actually blue, because it contains protein hemocyanin, which is a hemoglobin analog, containing copper ions instead of iron ions. The blue blood of horsehoe crabs is used for testing medical drugs for infections. It turns out that all the ordinary and common copper is not as simple as it seems to be. Now you know a little bit more about one of the other metals. If you would like to support the continuous production of science videos like this one, please support channel on Patreon, link in the video description. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel to see many more new and interesting.